Welcome to the first part of my Demon Souls weapon guide. In this video I will show you how to acquire all the weapons that are listed as trophy weapons in the Demon Souls wiki.wiki and thus required for the Gold Soldier's trophy. The Adjudicator's Shield is found at the Shrine of Storms 4-1 right from the beginning of the game. It recovers HP slowly over time and stacks with the Regenerator's Ring and Blessed weapons, hereby achieving very strong HP regeneration that lets you play the game almost entirely without healing grasses. The Baby's Nail is a dagger which can inflict plague on your enemy. It is a strong weapon in PvP, especially when used in the offhand as a surprise. You get it behind the altar in the Fool's Idol's boss room in 3-1. It is only accessible during the boss fight though. If you try to access the area after the fight is over, the cutscene will start and you can't reach the weapon anymore. You can also get it by killing Sage Break at any point in the game. Keep in mind though that killing Break will turn your character tendency towards pure black. The Blind is a weapon best used for a high dexterity build. It completely ignores any shield defense of your opponent and is extremely light. It is also very hard to get, for only Black Phantom 7 Vindant drops it in 5-2 Valley of Defilement when it is in pure black world tendency, and she can run and roll in the water. The Brand is the big ass hammer used by Gareth Vindant. He only drops it when killed a Black Phantom form in 5-3. This Phantom appears only when the Valley of Defilement is in pure white world tendency. Yes, pure white world tendency. Be careful, since this Black Phantom form has about 3 times as much hit points than his body form, and it also hits a lot harder. The Dark Silver Shield is dropped by Garvillain's body form in the main Astraea boss fight. To get it, you can either kill him and get it as a drop, or you can kill Astraea, return to the Nexus, and re-enter the boss room. The shield along with the set will be where Garl stood when you first entered the room. The Demon Brand is an heirloom of the Royal Boletarium family. It gets stronger as your character tendency is raised towards pure white. When you are at pure black character tendency, it does no damage at all. Old King Doran hands it over to you in the mausoleum in 1-1. Get the mausoleum key from Ostrava either by finishing a storyline or by killing him at any point in the game. Enter the mausoleum and talk to Old King Doran. He will attack you to test if you are worthy of the sword. Prove him that you are, and withdraw the sword from the plith. Thank you. The EP Rapier is the weapon used by Mephistopheles. You can find it as a treasure in 3-2 along with her gold mask after dropping the heart. Or by killing her at any point in the game. This little dagger was made by Gary, a friend of Sage Break. It absorbs a small amount of MP each time it hits an enemy. Sage Break endows it to you after you free him from a cell in 3-1 using the special key from the room above the Fool's Idol boss room. This is a katana without a hilt, forcing the wielder to grip the blade, slowly draining his HP with every successful hit. Only backstabs and riposte won't cost you HP. You can find it as a treasure in 4-2 near the boss room. Or get it as a drop from Black Phantom Satsuki in 4-1 when the Shrine of Storms is in pure Black World tendency. The Hands of God, Miyazaki's tribute to himself. These fist weapons can be found as a treasure right before the Flamebreaker boss room. Are obtained as a drop from each one of the blacksmiths. Neither of the smiths will turn hostile if the other one is killed. Keep in mind though that killing the blacksmith will turn your character tendency towards pure black. The Isterel is extremely difficult to get, especially in higher new game cycles. It is only accessible when the ladder appears in pure white world tendency in 5-1. This weapon is highly recommended for faith-based builds since it has an A scaling with that stat. The Dragon Bone Smasher can only be accessed if the Stonefang Tunnel is in pure White World tendency. You can get it in the Dragon God boss room to the left. This weapon is another of Gary's weapons and has the same effect as the Ring of Magical Sharpness. It increases both the magical damage you make and the amount of magical damage you take, and is found as a treasure in 3-1, right before the elevator down to the boss. This shield is used by Bjor and Bellapax of the Twin Fangs. It is a treasure in Mirella's Well, accessible after Boletaria has been in one of the two Pure World Tendencies. Or by killing Bjor at any point in the game. The large Sword of Moonlight is accessible after shooting or hitting down the Slug Nest in 5-2. Despite its size, it is one of the lightest weapons in the game, as the blade consists of moonlight. This is another great weapon for faith dedicated builds, and also it cannot be blocked by any shields. The magic sword Makoto is a katana that slowly drains your HP over time. Don't be alarmed though, since it is very strong and the amount of HP it takes from you can be as good as nullified with the Regenerator's Ring. You can find it as a treasure in 4-2 where the Shrine of Storms is in pure White Belt tendency. This sword is the kick-ass weapon used by the Penetrator boss in 1-3, where you can also find it as a treasure. The Black Phantom form of Mithas, one of the three trusted knights of King Alhant, also drops it in 1-4. The Phosphorescent Pole is dropped by the Black Phantom form of Lord Rudia in 3-1 when Latria is in pure Black World tendency. You don't have to free Rudia in order for the Phantom to appear. This weapon is highly recommended for intelligence-based builds. It also regenerates your MP over time and stacks with Crescent weapons and the Fragrant Ring for even more MP regeneration. Additionally, another Phosphorescent Pole can be acquired, which will also stack when it is on another level than the other Phosphorescent Pole. These two items are always found together. They are the weapon and shield used by Ostrava of Boletaria. One set is formed by dropping from ledge in 3-2. Another set can be acquired by killing the Black Phantom form of Ostrava in 1-4. You don't have to follow his storyline to encounter him here. If you want the sword and shield, he may not fall to his death, you have to kill him regularly. I could not do it successfully in either of my 3 playthroughs I did for this series, so I recommend just getting it from Latria. The Soul Brand is the counterpart to the Demon Brand. Its damage depends on your character tendency. When you are in pure white character tendency, it does no damage at all, whereas in pure black character tendency, it is incredibly strong. After killing Old King Aland at the very end of the game, this sword can be withdrawn from the ground. If you watch carefully during the fight, you can see it sticking in Old King Aland's shoulder. The Storm Ruler, a true trolling weapon, can be withdrawn from the cliff in the Storm King's boss room in 4-3. It is the only in-game weapon without any stat requirement. This handy talisman can cast both miracles and sorceries. You get as a quest reward from Mephistopheles after you killed Ostrava for her. Or is a drop from Black Phantom Scurver in 2-2 when Stonefang Tunnel is in pure Black World tendency. This is the shield used by the Tower Knight boss in 1-2. It is a drop from Alfred, one of King Alan's most trusted knights, who appears as a Black Phantom in 1-4. As well as a treasure in 1-2. The white bow is so unique that it can be obtained 3 times per playthrough. Either in the Shrine of Storms by following the path of the hidden passage, or by killing the Black Phantom form of Ulan, another of the trusted knights of King Aland in 1-4, or by trading a pure Moonlight Stone with Sparkly the Crow in 4-1. The stone, however, is such a rare drop that I personally do not recommend this particular way of obtaining the White Bow. Thank you very much for watching. I hope this guide was of help for you. If you have any questions, please feel free to post a comment. Check out my other guides for information on how to get all armor sets of the game and all the rings.